Hello everyone, today I, Soham, and my partner Sanvi are going to present on the topic digital payments.
Now the question arises, what do we mean by digital payment? A digital payment, sometimes called as an electronic payment, is the transfer of value from one payment account to another using a digital device such as mobile phone, POS terminals, etc. Also note that this definition includes the payments made with bank transfers, mobile money, and payment cards. A digital payment can take place on internet as well as on physical premises. For example, if you buy something from Amazon and pay for it via UPI, it qualifies as a digital payment. Similarly, if you purchase something from your local kirana store and choose to pay via UPI instead of handing over the cash, that also is a digital payment. There are various types and modes of digital payments. These include the use of debit and credit cards, POS terminals, internet banking, e-wallet, mobile money, and QR code.
The spread of COVID-19 has become one of the biggest threats of the global economy and financial markets. With economic growth expected to be severely hit, the financial outlook of digital payment sector is no different and will follow a similar trajectory, at least in the short term, but the industry's stability and potential for innovation will play an invaluable role in rebooting the economy in new normal. Adverse effects of COVID-19 pandemic are trickling down to major sectors of the Indian economy. The manufacturing, auto, retail, aviation and hospitality bearing the brunt of the lockdown. This in turn has affected fast-growing digital payments which are closely linked to the aforementioned sectors. Shut shops, travel bans, reduced discretionary spends by consumers are further negatively impacting digital payments. Digital payment volume declines are seen in airlines, tourism, hospitality, hotels, entertainment, e-commerce and restaurants, among other sectors. The pre-COVID situation, world economic situation and prospects 2019 offers timely warnings about a range of macroeconomic challenges facing policymakers as they aim to deliver on the 2030 agenda for sustainable development. Sectorial impact. Payment players will be impacted differently depending upon their exposure to various sectors. This view has been taken keeping in mind a time frame of at least 6 months for these sectors. Aviation. An acquirer with large exposure to the aviation industry is at risk due to the threat posed by increased refunds and chargebacks at flights are cancelled across the board. Tourism and hospitality. Acquirers having a large exposure of the hospitality industry will face headwinds as complete the lockdown restricts business on a very large extent and digital payments are restricted to use. COVID scenario continues to unfold, its impact on the behavior of expectations of customers as well as those of businesses will become more apparent. However, what is clear now is that we will settle into normal once the pandemic dies down. To be aid and recovery and lead the emergence into this new normal, it is imperative for the digital payments ecosystem to evolve rapidly and help shape the post-COVID era. We look at a few fundamentals that will drive the way forward. Short term, banks offering fee waiver on select digital payments like NEFT, RTGS, and cash withdrawals from third-party ATMs. RBI offering a 3-month moratorium on loans and credit card dues, expected to avail this all the interest as the interest charges will be very high. Immediate financial assistance from the government through new schemes and etc. Long-term plans may include increase in transactions being converted into EMIs owing to slowdown, increase in usage of DPT rails by government, contactless payments, SMS link based payments and wearables will see an uptick, increase in customer education initiatives and measures to combat fraud, increase in virtual card issuance and usage, increased in online presence of small and medium businesses. Payment processors will be encouraged to invest in service quality and to increase infrastructure and capacity. Online, paperless processes to issue products like unsecured loans and credit cards without any in-person contact. Shift in consumer behavior, greater adoption of digital payments. Rapid build-out of omni-channel capabilities.